It was supposed to be the trip of a lifetime. But coming up on Neighbours, the plane goes down. Neighbours is next.
No. Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Get off me, you bastard! Just relax, relax, oi! Come here, relax.
Dylan Timmons, where is he?
I don't know.
Where is he?
I don't know, all right?
Listen, I've just spoken to the pilot, and the ground crew have informed him that the police are going to be meeting this plane when it lands in Launceston.
Well, that's it then.
China hopes to transform their nanotech industry by the year 2002.
Yeah, well, enough nano talk. We're supposed to be living it up.
Hey, I was fascinated.
Yeah, I bet you were.
Hang on, I thought you loved me for my mind.
No, purely physical.
Oh, really?
That's funny. Lil says that about me too.
All the time. Cute note.
Sorry?
To my one and only.
What is it?
I thought you could tell me. I found it behind my tray. You didn't put it there?
No, never seen it before.
Well, what does it mean? Think about your life. Why would I need to do that?
Oh, Izzy, it wouldn't be meant for you. It was probably just left over from a previous flight, you know?
Hey, Paul. What's this place like we're going? Alex and I are just wondering about the facilities.
Yeah, I'll be back in a tick.
Your idea of a joke, is it?
What?
I've done enough thinking lately. More than enough. My problems are in the past. Thanks very much. I'm actually happy with my life for a change.
Well, good for you. But I didn't do this.
Wouldn't surprise me. Think what you like. I've got nothing to do with your stupid little note.
Around, Scott. We know Dylan did the hold-up. We've got his prints on the weapon and a positive ID from the victim. So what was your involvement? You can make life a lot easier for yourself just by telling the truth.
Look, I'm not saying a word until Toddy gets back.
Do you realise what you're facing? Accessory to armed robbery. That's not a slap on the wrist, OK? It's a long-term jail sentence.
Yes, thank you very much, Constable. Can I have some time alone with my client, please? Interview suspended at 18:55. Talk some sense into your client.
Okay.
Tell me exactly what happened.
I can't, all right? I told Dylan I'd keep my gob shut.
Okay, the time for that has passed, Stingray. Whatever you and Dylan have got yourselves into, you need to tell me. Then I can come up with some kind of plan for court. I'm on your side, dammit, all right? I'm family.
Look, I promised him that I wouldn't tell the family.
Okay, well then forget I'm family. Cousin Toddy just walked out the door. I'm your solicitor. I need to know everything that happened so I can work out what to tell them, what not to tell them, and give you some kind of fighting chance. So tell me the truth. Now.
Not bad. Your old mum doesn't scrub up too badly, does she?
Hello? Oh, my God, yes. Hold on a second. Mum.
What, love? Who is it?
It's a publisher.
What?
About your book.
But I never sent it to any publisher. The only reason anyone reads is because... Hang on a minute. I know what this is all about. Give me that.
Mum.
Come on. Janelle Timmons. Righto, turn it up. How stupid do you think I am? You've never read a book in your life. You're just some tart that idiot face Mangle has set up to pretend to be a publisher. Oh. Yeah, that's right. I'm onto you, love. And I'm onto Mangle too. I bet he's there, laughing it up. Well, when I'm done with him, he won't know what hit him. He's a dead man. Did you hear that, Mangle? A dead man! Huh. Gotta get up pretty early in the morning to get one over me.
Mum.
Well, they had it coming to them.
That was Melody Jones.
Yeah, so she said, little floozy.
Do you know who that is?
Well, should I?
She's only the biggest publisher in Melbourne. She's on TV and everything.
What? Oh, you mean...
Yeah, she was a real publisher wanting to publish your book. I recognised her voice.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God, what have I done?
That'll be her again.
Well, what do I say? I called her a tart.
Just don't say anything stupid.
Janelle Timmons.
And it took us ages to walk back to the allotment.
Right, and that's where you burnt the evidence. Answer yes or no, please.
Yes.
Right. And you divvied up the proceeds of the robbery after that?
No, look, I've already told you this. Rue took the money.
Right. Just before he magically disappeared into thin air. Is there anything else you'd like to add, Scott?
Dylan didn't have any choice. All right, you've got to believe me. If he hadn't robbed the joint, Rue or Terry, they would have killed me.
Yeah, so you keep saying. Right, interview terminated at 19:10.
Tiny flutter at the casino tonight. Would you get all, you know, self-righteous on me?
But me, self-righteous? Yep. You? No. No.
What?
Oh. So I'm gonna go straight to the cops when we get back to Melbourne.
Connor.
Look, no, seriously. I betrayed Toadie and the girl I love. And I stole from you both. Nobody can forget that or forgive it.
Scott, put yourself in my shoes, okay? On one hand, we've got Dylan's previous form, fingerprints on the weapon, and a positive ID from the victim, and on the other, we've got this story about a crazy jail escapee out for revenge who wasn't seen by anyone.
Yeah, what about Rue Houseman? I'm sure there's records showing when he escaped.
Yeah, I do know my job, mate, thanks. Anyway, even if he was out, it's circumstantial.
Look, Dylan dobbed Rue into the cops last time he was in town. Who else would be out there to bring him down?
You and Dylan have had weeks to concoct a cover story. Frankly, I'm surprised the pair with so much history haven't come up with something a little bit more plausible.
Don't bite. Cops try this stuff all the time.
Look, what's going to happen now? I mean, with Dylan?
Our police unit will be meeting the plane in Launceston. The rest is up to the courts.
You know, there is a certain club we can join while we're on board. Oh, but of course, darling.
Oi, what's up? What's wrong?
Oh, no.
Come on, Dale, give.
I guess everyone's gonna find out soon anyway.
She said it was, a delightful pack stitch of suburban life.
Pastiche.
What?
A pastiche of suburban life.
Yeah, whatever. And a cutting satirical statement on the modern novel. Not bad, eh? Oh, who's laughing now?
So you're really going to be a published novelist?
Oh, once they may be, it will be a done deal, I reckon. How good is that? Oh, think of the dough, kiddo. Think of the dough. Money, money, money. We're going to be rich. We're going to be rich. We're going to...
What?
Oh, nothing. I was just a bit giddy. Oh, must be my eyes.
I'm aiming to ditch approximately 5 miles short of the coast.
You sleep with your seatbelt on.
I'll make it now.
Get back to your seat.
Report engine.
What's going on? We've been trying to get this plane to safety. Get back now.
Will we make it to dry land?
Now, no.
0.71. That's
pilots are doing everything they can. The emergency services would have been notified by now, so everything's been done.
Right, thanks. I guess our job is to stay calm and be prepared. Serena, have you read the safety card?
What?
Read it. Could save your life.
Susan, if things do end up badly, what's going to happen to Rachel and Zeke? I hope they've got no one.
Carl will look after them.
Carl?
Yeah, I know he will.
South Carl,
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry for all the terrible things that I said and the things we said to each other. I regret everything in it. And I'm holding him now that I'm holding you.
Dylan will be apprehended the moment he lands. We expect to be charged with armed robbery.
No!
Plus firearms offences.
Yeah. What about Scotty?
Looks like he'll be facing a charge of accessory to armed robbery.
Which could be dropped when the cops do their job and find out the facts.
Bloody Dylan.
Mum!
No, that is it. I finally had it with that boy. He got you into this.
Mum, it wasn't his fault. All right? He was forced to
do it. Stop it, Scotty. You're always defending him. Very sweet, but grow up. You can stop lying for him now.
Janelle! You didn't hear that, mate, did you? Can I just grab a couple of minutes here?
5 minutes.
Thanks.
I love my mum. I mean, I really love her.
You hear that, Mum?
So this is going to be like another adventure, yeah? Like a Big Dipper or something?
Bigger. Good luck, babe. We're going to go out with a laugh.
So I'm really going to see what's out there. You know, like life afterwards. I might even see my mum.
You will. Come on.
Let's do this!
We've had fun together, haven't we? Hey? Just being together. Me having the chance to be a real father to you again. Giving me a second chance at life, my baby girl.
Bad. He's been bad since the day he was born. I should have sent him packing when he got out of juvie last time. And oh no, I gave him another chance.
Yeah, Mum, and look what he's done. He's finished school, he's got a job, he's bringing money home. And plus, he's been a real good brother to me, Janae, and Scotty. And he's not bad. He's not.
He's been a better son to you than I have, Mum.
No. He is no son of mine. Not anymore.
Negative. We have not enough fuel. We run out of fuel.
Give up hope, all right? Good girl, Nick. Give us, sit down. Put your belt on, lovey.
So short a time, and I've fallen in love with you so much.
just about.
There's no one like you in the world. And you happen to me. That's amazing. One life's not enough. I want a whole nother one just to live with you.
Oh, shut up.
We're down to 300 feet.
Ladies and gentlemen, adopt the brace position now.
Good luck, everyone. And remember the safety drill. My God, we will.
Listening. Okay, the only reason that Dylan got involved was because that hufter Rue kidnapped me.
Rue and your brother are losers and crooks from way back. That ram-red in Colac.
Let's not get sidetracked.
Oh, mind your own
butt
business.
Out, Toadie.
It's where it all started. You wouldn't be mixed up in all this if it wasn't for Dylan.
Oh, mother of Spig and Pearl. Mum, okay, this happened because Dylan was trying to do the right thing. All right, get Rue out of his life.
Oh, and how is knocking off a petrol station with Rue getting him out of his life? Stop defending him!
How are we going to pay for it?
Eh?
Well, we're going to need barristers and stuff for Scotty and Dill. How are we going to get the money for that?
Don't worry.
Yeah, it's okay. We'll find the money for Scotty and Dylan can go whistle.
I'll represent them both, pro bono if need be. You don't need to worry about the money. What, you got a problem with that, have you?
The plane's gone down.
What are you talking about?
Well, that flight to Launceston. Connor, Dylan, the others. I just heard it over the radio. They've crashed in the Bass Strait.
Thank you.
with this weird in here, okay? I won't be far off.
I'm so cold.
I know you're cold, babe. I know you're cold. Look, it'll be all right. All right, listen. Listen. We're gonna get out of this, okay? That's a promise.
Oh, my God. What was that?
We have to get out of here before 6, okay? What was that?
What was what?
Oh,
Dave.
There was somebody. I heard it. We have to get out of here. We can't take our life jackets because we won't be able to swim under with them all, okay?
We'll drown!
No, we won't. We'll be fine, all right? You can do it, all right? All right? We both can do it, okay?
Okay.
You ready? You ready? Don't let go of me. You ready? All right. 1, 2, 3.
Tonight, TEN's new series is putting all your unanswered questions to the test. Are you ready for the truth? All new Brainiac, 8:30 tonight on TEN, followed by Rove Live. Stay with us now for Everybody Loves Raymond.